David Sifman has an exclusive. Mike Bloomberg and his people are stonewalling the investigation, the Hagerty trial. They want Mike Bloomberg's emails, and Mike Bloomberg doesn't want to give them up. Approximately 62 emails. Okay, this is Mike Bloomberg's Watergate. That's number one. Number two, we need a higher court. The Manhattan DA cannot handle this for several reasons. One, Mike Bloomberg holds the purse strings. Number two, Cy Vance, Manhattan DA, owes Guma, a guy that worked on his campaign, money. Okay, it's so expensive to run for office. So I really think there needs to be a cap to avoid things like this, cap for everybody. But he owes this guy, Guma, who's married to Keeney. Keeney, Maura Keeney, worked with Hagerty for Bloomberg, okay? She's also written up in a scandalous piece with Christine Quinn about improprieties. It's written by Jim Dwyer of the New York Times. I can add links into the text portion of this New York Post. For those reasons alone, Mike Bloomberg, the Hagerty trial, the scandal, needs to be investigated by people that Mike Bloomberg doesn't hold the purse strings to. This is scandalous and shocking, and it made me think of Steve Rattner. Steve Rattner pleaded the fifth more times than Mike Bloomberg's run for mayor. Steve Rattner was less than forthcoming with Cuomo and the Security Exchange Commission over his role in the pay-to-play pension fund, and he says that he's innocent, but in every way he appears guilty, and not being forthcoming and pleading the fifth over and over is a good sign. Same with Bloomberg. Why withhold these? He says it's personal. I'm not buying that. On top of which, as you know, if you read the comment that I posted on the New York Post and I'm going to put on my blogs, I've been harassed nonstop. Aggravated harassment on the computer. Tony Avella's identity was stolen. He's not a YouTube person. He's not a member. His identity was stolen to harass me the day after the election. The harassment continues on. So if we get higher authorities to investigate this, pretty confident you're going to find a lot more campaign improprieties, and I believe that there's laws that have been broken, criminal. So this is good work on David's part of the New York Post.